Arizona. MLB The Show is on the air. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the Cleveland Indians and the Arizona Diamondbacks. Michael Brantley strides forward, and we are set for baseball here this evening.
Number 23.
And a cold strike on the game's first pitch as we bring you this one here tonight. Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1. Slider clocked in the mid-80s there. It's a ball and two strikes. Here's Greinke's 1-2. Swing and a ball hit well to the right side, but this will get into the crowd. Here's another 1-2. And he takes strike three called on the fastball, and the leadoff man is gone to start the evening. So the base is empty here with one away. And standing in now, the power-hitting second baseman, Jason Kipnis. Here's the first pitch now from Greinke. And he lays off there, 1-0. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
And on 2-0, this is where he's the most dangerous up there. I know it's a fastball count, but I would maybe think about something else.
Swing and a miss on the heater, and it's 2-1.
And that had all the looks of a guy who was going to take a giant hack, 2-0, no matter where that pitch was. EK, I know you never did that.
Not me. Maybe once or twice.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
And like most guys, the further ahead in the count he gets, the more dangerous he becomes. He's going to lock in on one pitch, one zone, and he'll hurt you if he guesses right.
Now the pitch. And here's a ball out towards straightaway center field. Catch made out there by Pollock, and there are two away now.
Batting third, shortstop,
Francisco Lindor gets his first opportunity now in the top of the first with nobody on. Drops in a strike to start the at-bat. Nothing in one.
He's probably not going to throw too many first-pitch changeups. That's a pretty darn good call.
Hit hard toward the right side. He lays out for it, but he can't pull it in. The throw into second. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
Yeah, no hesitation there as we train our camera directly on him. Once this gets down the line, he's thinking two right out of the box, and he's able to beat the throw into second and leg out a double.
In now, Edwin Encarnacion. As he takes a cold strike at the knees, it's 0-1.
All of a sudden, you got to be careful now with the cleanup guy up there with a runner in scoring position. He could be in danger of giving up that first run after all.
And he misses there, 1-2.
And that's the spot that he's just going to have to keep wearing out going forward. If he can keep running that pitch in on the guy's hands, he's going to be fine.
Good fastball swung on and missed for strike three, and the inning is over. Danger averted following the two-out double. We'll come right back with more from Chase Field following this. defensively, the Indians will line up this way. Ketel Marte comes to the plate to lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
The shortstop, Ketel Marte.
And first pitch swinging as this is bounced on the ground towards short.
After that.
Throw on to first, and one shortstop grounds out to the other, one away.
Yeah, probably not an ideal at-bat from your leadoff hitter here in the first. I'd like him to stretch that count a little, try and work his way on base. Instead, he rolls over on the first pitch, and he's gone before you know it.
The pitch. Now the second. And this is going to wind up hitting the bag at third. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely.
Sometimes when you know that you're not going to have a play, this is what you have to do. Here, no shot to throw him out down there at third. So he's just going to play it smart, take a bite out of it.
Into the box now, Paul Goldschmidt. Yes, he'll pick on the first pitch and hit a ground ball towards second. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. 4-6-3. They roll it up to get out of the jam. Jose Ramirez will lead things off here as it'll be 5, 6, and 7 due up to kick off the second. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
Ah, that thing's knee-high on the outside third of the plate. Pretty understandable why he couldn't catch up with that one.
Good changeup, and it's 0-2. Now here it comes. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
Well, one thing you can always say when you're facing a guy like this is that he's gonna strike hitters out. The question is, are you gonna make him work for those strikeouts? And if those three pitches are any indication at all, these guys could be in for a long night.
Here it comes. First pitch here is popped a mile high into the air. This is way up there, but playable on the infield. And two quick outs here in the second.
This is where having a good changeup can save some wear and tear on your arm. It takes him just four pitches to get the first two outs here.
Roberto Perez is at the plate now, and he's quickly behind 0-1.
Yeah, you know, first time through, he likes to start guys off with a fastball, and it's a good one, too. You know, he'll run it up there in the mid-90s.
Hard stuff on the corner, and he's got him 0-2 now. Out in front as this is drilled into left field. That's a base hit.
It wasn't just that he was getting fastballs there. He was getting hittable fastballs. This catches a ton of the plate. He turns it around for a solid single.
Stepping in now, Tyler Naquin. A little late on this one as it's lifted the other way down the left field line. Tomas is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. One. David Peralta strides into the box now to lead off the home half of the second inning. Pitch on the way. Well struck, but foul over by the coaching box. I got the high fastball there, and he popped it straight up. Kipnis is underneath this one, and he puts it away for the first down.
Batting fifth, left fielder,
Yasmani Tomas steps into the box. Fouled back. Here's the pitch. And this is bounced foul at the plate, and that moves the count to 0-2 now. Looked like the cut fastball there, and he got him to swing through it for the second out. Jake Lamb gets his first chance here, looking to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Hit hard, but foul. Bottom of the second here with no score. Here's a ground ball to first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Trevor Bauer set to lead off the third. 9-1-2 due up.
Trevor Bauer.
Here's the first pitch now from Greinke. Slice down the line at first. This gets foul. It's 0-1. Off the plate and in. It's a ball and a strike. A good action on the two-seamer there, and it's 1-2. Boy, tough enough to be an American League pitcher swinging the bat as it is. How about having to deal with pitches like that?
One word, Matty, unfair.
Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out.
Well, it's always nice to get the inning started against the pitcher. And he sets him down easily for the first out of the third.
This ball's hit in the air down the right side and out of play. 0-1. Now here's the pitch. That misses wide. One ball and one strike. Bases are empty, one man out. Fouled straight back. Here's Greinke's 1-2. And that is through into center field for a one-out single.
You talk about getting the bat head out in front. This is rifled up the middle. Can't square up a baseball any better than that.
Standing in now, Jason Kipnis. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. Slider taken here. One ball, one strike.
And that's the right spot for that slider. Really try hard to tie him up inside. And that's a good job to lay off, too.
Find that fastball's too much for him there. 1-2. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
Yeah, an interesting setup now on 2-2. Here's where you really need to pay attention to that guy at first.
And this is heading out toward left field, but this is going to get fouled up into the crowd. Here's another 2-2. And this is swung on and missed. His fifth strikeout already, and there are two gone in the inning.
Now batting.
Francisco Lindor walks into the box, reached base with a double his first time up. From the belt, the pitch. Starts things here with a changeup for a called strike. A runner on first with two away. Swing and he popped him up over in foul territory back behind third. And Lamb will put this one away, and that ends the inning. Indians leave one. Home half of the third coming up. No score.
Leading off for the Diamondbacks.
Chris Iannetta digs into the box in the bottom of inning number three. Now the pitch. And this ball's going to find the seats down the left field line. Foul, strike one. And Iannetta can't come up with that one as he swings through it for strike two now.
And I think he'll keep riding that pitch until these guys prove they can do something with it.
In front of the changeup there as this is chopped foul at home plate. The next 0-2. And here's one that misses, so the count runs to 1-2 now on Iannetta.
Jeez, finally. That's the first ball they've taken all night. About time, boys.
And my gracious, that really drilled him as it rolls toward the first baseline. And the recovery's a quick one as he gets his man at first. Good composure that time to record the first out of the inning. Leadoff man set down, and here's Chris Owings. The pitch. And a feeble swing that time. It's 0-1. And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground. But that'll get fouled. It's 0-2 now. Bottom of inning number three, nothing our score. Out of play. Here comes another 0-2. And he gets under this one and, in fact, breaks his bat as this one's popped up. Just foul. Ready with another 0-2. Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out. Zach Greinke stands in for the first time. Now here's the pitch. In there, 0-1.
Oh, that's a thing of beauty right there.
Two out, nobody on. Oh, he lifts a high pop-up, drifting into foul territory on the right side. Encarnacion will put this one away, and the side is retired. Edwin Encarnacion is ready here as we begin the top of the fourth.
First baseman number 10, Edwin Encarnacion.
Here it comes. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. Throw to first in time, one gone here in the fourth. Jose Ramirez is into the box. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. Ball hit high and foul down the left field line. It's strike one. And he makes good contact there, but this is going to find the stands foul down the right field line. And this is fouled at the plate. Slowly down the line to third. Could be a tough play. And they will not get him at first as he's able to leg out the throw.
Much easier to do in retrospect, but you almost wonder if he would have been better served to let this ball go and see if it would have gone foul. There's no guarantees it would have, but that was always going to be a tough play anyway.
Into the box, Lonnie Chisenhall. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. Runners on the move for second. And this is going to be fouled into the diamond level seats. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two. Roberto Perez will dig in. He singled his first time around. Has a look, now the pitch. And here's a fastball called for strike one. No runs, four hits. No errors to this point for the Indians. And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
And that's almost a carbon copy of that last fastball, and he buried both of those pitches right on the inside corner.
Another 0-2 home. On the ground down the first baseline, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Ketel Marte is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning. Oh, hit sharply as this is pulled into right. Now a reach, and he takes a tumble here, but hangs on for the first out.
And let's check this one out again. Look at him stretch out for this thing, and then he's going to tuck into a nice little barrel roll at the end there. That was pretty sweet.
In now, A.J. Pollock. Here's a swing and a ground ball, but a foul ball here, 0-1. Off the plate, one ball, one strike.
And if he can get himself into a fastball count, don't be surprised if he has a big cut at something. Maybe try and break this tie ball game.
Up high, 2-1 now. One out, nobody on. And this is on the inside edge, perhaps off the inside edge, but it's a called strike, 2-2 now. 2-2 pitch pulled on the ground down to third. Throw in time at first for out number two. Paul Goldschmidt will stand in now with two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Now, this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
Here's a swing and a high pop-up, drifting toward the third base dugout. Toward the dugout. Did he catch it? He did! What a play there to end the inning. So 1-2-3 go the Diamondbacks. Through four, still tied, nothing. Tyler Naquin heads for the box to start off the fifth in this one.
Tyler Naquin.
And he swings on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. Curveball close, but it's 1-1. And he'll try and catch him by surprise here as he drops this one down. And the throw will be too late, so it's a bunt single to get him started here.
The pitcher number 47, Trevor Bauer.
Into the box now, Trevor Bauer. And they'll indeed have the pitcher squaring around as he puts this one down. And he will not have a play behind him. It's an infield single. So definite problems on that last play, and they'll hit the first baseman for the error. Michael Brantley will stand in now with two on here and nobody out to begin the inning.
And on the mound, he hasn't found himself in too many rough spots so far, so this might be his first real test of the ballgame.
He waits, now the pitch. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one.
Now with two on, nobody out, you got to be thinking strikeout double play out there on the mound. One or the other is what you really need.
Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. And he's retired here, one away.
And now that would have fallen under the infield fly rule if it was a fair ball. But no matter, it goes over to make the catch here in foul territory.
Jason Kipnis comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. He's ready now, the pitch. And he takes this one high, 1-1. No runs, five hits, No errors to this point for the Indians. Swing and he pulls the fastball high in the air toward deep right center. Pollard, the range to his left and put it away. Two down.
I think at first he probably had thoughts about tagging up here, but there's that old baseball adage, don't make the last out of the inning at third base. So staying at second, probably the right call.
Tries to go the other way as this is in the air to left field. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. A golden opportunity to get on the board. Here goes for naught. David Peralta comes to the plate as we get started here in the bottom of the fifth.
David Peralta.
Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground is short. And he's retired one away. A little bit over halfway home tonight. Bottom of the fifth as we get a look at our line score to this point. And boy, just one hit for these guys, and they have not swung the bats well. That's putting it mildly. Now the pitch. And now the second pitch of the inning is in the air to right. Chisenhall is in his tracks now, and he's got it for out number two.
Yeah, it's not like he needed any help. He's pitching well enough as it is, but this is now two pitches and two outs here in the inning. And he's growing more and more confident with every passing batter.
On the ground towards second. On to first, and can you believe it? A three-pitch inning. And just Edwin Encarnacion will stand in to get things going for the Indians in their half of the sixth. Here's the first pitch now from Greinke. And a check swing here, but he clearly went around on a pitch that would have been a strike anyway. It's nothing and one. Fastball called for strike two. Lifted down the line in right and back out of play. Count holds it 0-2. Now here it comes. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one.
I think we expected to see a well-pitched game coming in, and we got one. Starting to look like the team who scores first might be the one who wins.
Fouled back. Bases are empty, one man out. And here's a curveball in the dirt that time for a ball. 1-1. 1-2 now.
And that has been the comfort zone so far in this outing. He's just lived on that outside corner, and it's paid big dividends for him.
That misses, and we're even at 2-2. And he struck him out. Strikeout number eight now in the ballgame for him.
Two straight strikeouts here to start out the inning, but that's eight for him now in the ballgame. These guys have really had a hard time figuring him out.
And that swung on and fouled straight back. Now here's the pitch. On, could we see another strikeout here? It's 0-2 now.
And it looks like the scouting report says, work this guy away, and it's been paying off.
And whoever put together that scouting report did a real nice job, because this whole team hasn't done much offensively at all.
And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Chris Iannetta gets things started here in the sixth for the hometown team. Now the pitch. Here's a swing and a shot back up the middle. And he is going to reach. It's a base hit.
Now batting, second baseman.
Chris Owings comes to the plate looking to put the ball in play. He went down on strikes last time. He's ready. Now the pitch. Now a bunt attempt, but this one might have too much on it. Throws in time, and that's out number one.
Another guy retired there. You see his pitching line to this point. It's phenomenal. Just two hits. Both of them are singles. And he's hardly even been in trouble. Thorough domination so far.
Zach Greinke stands in as the batter now, and with the runner already in scoring position and one away, he likely won't be bunting here. Comes set, now the pitch. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. On to first, and there are two down. Ketel Marte will try things again. He's grounded out and lined out in two trips. Try to crowd him there to start the at-bat. It's 1-0. Opposite field to left. And that's in there. Base hit. Oh, and he runs right through the stop sign. And a relay to the plate. And he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late.
We knew this game wouldn't stay nothing-nothing forever. Now, here in the sixth inning, the question will be, can they add on?
Comes set, now the pitch. A.J. Pollock stands in as he swings and misses for strike one.
A lot of these guys have come into these at-bats trying to be the aggressor, trying to make something happen. But what has happened is that they've swung and missed themselves into some early holes.
And Chisenhall will make the catch, and the side is retired. A run on a couple of hits here for Arizona. Roberto Perez will come forward now to begin the seventh inning in what's been a very briskly played ball game here tonight.
That's what happens when you get two starters that are on top of their game. It's been great pitching, great defense, not a lot of base runners, and a very even game through six innings.
And here's a fastball in for strike one. 91 miles an hour that time. 1-2.
Oh, another good pitch there. I'm not sure he's thrown a bad slider tonight. Every one of them has had a ton of movement.
And he reaches for one out of his own and misses rather badly for the first out.
And we'll check out the pitches by inning. And you can see he's up to even 80 pitches now. So I'd imagine they'll start keeping a little closer tabs on him out there.
Tyler Naquin steps in, working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Checks his swing, but this pitch is right there for strike one.
Yeah, he's definitely still bringing it. It's the seventh inning, and we're still hearing the catcher's mitt snapping all the way up here.
Good change up there as he takes command, 0-2. And he struck him out. So double digits now, 10 strikeouts for him thus far. Austin Jackson will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run.
Austin Jackson.
And he just keeps rolling along as he starts another batter out with strike one.
If I didn't know any better, I think this was his first inning out there. He's still throwing the ball with a lot of velocity.
And this is swung on and bounced up the center of the diamond. And a great diving effort there, but it'll just tip off his glove, and it's a base hit.
Now batter.
Michael Brantley will bat now. He popped out in foul ground last time. He's set, now the pitch. First pitch here misses wide, 1-0.
Now you've got the tying run over at first, two away. He's going to be looking to try and find a gap right here and bring that guy all the way around to score.
And he'll be tagged out at second base. trying to get into scoring position, but instead the inning is over. Brian Shaw will get the ball now as he'll take over on the mound to start the home seventh. Paul Goldschmidt will bat now. He popped out in foul ground last time. Action going on now in the Indians bullpen as they have a left-hander up and getting loose. Good swing there, but this is foul off to the right side. Here's the pitch. And he squares this one nicely, and it's lined into center field for a leadoff single.
You talk about getting the bat head out in front. This is rifled up the middle. Can't square up a baseball any better than that.
David Peralta will dig in for a third time now. He's popped out and grounded out so far. Pause, now the pitch. Here's a hard hit ball ripped down the first base line. Step on the bag for one, and it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw.
You know, that's one that you just don't see that often. Safe at second base, but out at first. Just shows you the speed he has at first base that he was able to beat the throw into second.
Fooled him a bit as this is hit high in the air towards right center and shallow. Chisenhall has a long run, but he takes charge for out number two. Jake Lamb will stand in again. A couple of ground outs for him on the ledger in his two trips so far. Some stirring now in the Cleveland bullpen. They'll get both a left-hander and a right-hander up and throwing. And there's the fourth wide one, so he's aboard on the intentional walk.
Yeah, they decide they don't even want to mess around with this guy. With his track record, it's hard to say you blame him. Let somebody else beat you.
As a look, now the pitch. Takes a good swing, but this will be a foul ball. Two down, runners at first and second. Waved at and missed, and he's behind 0-2.
Boy, when he's got that thing going good, it just takes a nosedive right at the end.
And he reaches for one but can't find it as he's down on strikes for the final out. Diamondbacks grand a pair, but they're up 1-0. Michael Brantley will step in to lead it off for Cleveland. He'll be followed in the order by Jason Kipnis. Pitch on the way. Now he turns on a fastball here and sends it to deep right field. Peralta is there to put it away, and they couldn't ask for more than a one pitch out to begin the eighth. Jason Kipnis will stand in for the fourth time now, still looking for his first hit of the ball game.
And he's not the only one either. This has been a great pitching performance so far, and they've had these guys chasing their tails all game long.
He'll get it into second. The tag, and he's out at second base. He probably should have stayed right where he was.
Francisco Lindor.
Francisco Lindor gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in three tries to this point. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. And this is heading for the seats and out of play to the left. And he's right on the fastball there, hit pretty well out towards deep left. Tomas is there, and it's a very quick inning as the side is retired. Jeff Manship is on out of the bullpen now as he'll take over to start the bottom of the eighth. Chris Owings will stand in. Sacrifice bunt his last time. And this one's chopped foul right at home plate. Here it comes. Late on the fastball there as this one skied out toward right. And Chisenhall calls for it and takes it for the first down.
Pitcher number 21.
Zach Greinke will buy himself another at-bat, and in turn he'll get himself a nice little ovation for the work he's turned in on the mound so far.
He's been great. This is an appreciative crowd. They like what they've seen, and I don't blame them.
Righty against righty as this is taken for a ball. It's 1-0. Now here's a swing, and the ball hit well out there toward right center. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now.
That actually wasn't too bad a swing there. Sometimes you can catch those outfielders playing far too shallow with a pitcher up there, but he was able to keep this one in his sights and make the play.
There's a breaking ball fouled off to the left for strike one. Turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. And, oh, he missed a home run by a matter of feet. It's off the wall. And now that'll hop over the wall. So he'll be at second here with two away on a ground rule double. A.J. Pollock takes his turn now, looking to add some insurance to their lead in the form of that run standing out at second base. A late swing here as this is hit hard to the right side. And Encarnacion will take this to the bag, and the inning is over. Edwin Encarnacion will be tasked now with leading things off in their half of the ninth as they'll try to do something to prevent being shut out.
And whatever they've done for the first eight innings hasn't yielded a whole lot so far, so quite frankly, I'm not expecting too much.
Your attention, please.
And a save situation here, so on comes the right-hander, Fernando Rodney. Off we go in the ninth as the first pitch misses for ball one.
And that fastball has definitely catches your attention, especially when it's on the inner half.
And the off-speed pitch is taken here, a ball and a strike.
And you can see him trying to be a little bit more patient here. He's got two strikeouts already, but he's got to be careful not to fall too far behind.
And he is down on strikes again. So get your hats out. That's the third strikeout of the game.
We'll get a good look at the grip on this last circle change. You can see that your fingers actually make kind of an okay symbol on the side of the baseball, and that gives it that nice fading movement it has at the end.
Standing in now, Jose Ramirez. As he'll pick on the first pitch and hit a ground ball towards second. Throw on the first, and now the Indians are down to their final out.
And that's a good guy to take care of on one pitch, especially on a swing like that.
Lonnie Chisenhall stands into the box. He could really use a knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far. First pitch fastball swung on and missed 0-1. Should the lead hold up in this one, the win would belong to Zach Greinke. And this ball's in the air to left field, and this should do it. Tomas is there to make the catch, and with that, the ball game is over.
Wow, just a really great game to watch from beginning to end. A well-pitched 1-0 ball game. This is just a broadcaster's dream.
Time for one final check of the line score as you see the key players there in this shutout victory.